Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Lala Living here and I'm back again with another video. As you can tell by the scrubs, it is dental hygiene related, and today I'm going to be going over the breakdown of the dental hygiene program semester by semester. And so you guys, if you don't know, I am a senior right now inside the dental hygiene program, and so I'm basically on my last classes, so I know exactly the way it goes down. Some schools are different, but I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys know how my school did it. Before we get into this video, you guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit your post notification bell so you don't miss no more uploads. If you're trying to become a dental hygienist or even just interested in dental hygiene, you want to make sure to hit your post notification bell so you don't miss any uploads. Like this video and don't forget to leave a comment of any questions that you have or any videos that you want to see me actually film, okay? So basically the dental hygiene program runs anywhere from about 6 semesters to 8 semesters, so about a year and a half to 2 years. And so my program is a 6 semester course. So you guys, for my particular program, they used to start inside the fall, but my year, my grade, my class, we started in the summer semester, and that's what they do now. So we started in the summer of 2019 and we took 2 classes. It was oral embryology and histology, and we also took head and neck. These 2 classes are a beast, okay? And when I say they are a beast, they really are. They go from learning the embryology as far as the different developments inside a child. You learn about the tooth bud and the different parts. And then you also have head and neck, where you learn all about the anatomy of the cranial nerves, the trigeminal nerve. You will, if you're in dental hygiene school right now, you already know the trigeminal nerve is the nerve of, it's the nerve of all questions, okay? So basically, those 2 courses, they go hand in hand because it's all about, you know, the developmental, and you really understand how they connect. And so those were the 2 courses that we started out with. And then inside the fall, we had tooth anatomy and root morphology, which was basically learning about teeth. And this was the class that I started to really understand how teeth were being numbered and everything, because like I told you guys in my first video, when I was just letting you guys know everything you need to know before dental hygiene school, I didn't know teeth number, I didn't know about the x-ray and a lot of things. So like I told you guys, you will learn everything you need to know in the program. So don't be scared to enter the program because you feel like you don't have enough knowledge. That's what the program is for. It's going to teach you everything you need to know. So I really like tooth anatomy. It was really fun. We even had to like mold some teeth out of clay, and we had to make sure it had all the characteristic of that particular teeth. Like we had to do some molars. I think we had to do a premolar, a central incisor, and definitely we had to do a canine. We also took dental materials that semester. And like the name suggests, it's just learning about the different materials that you'll be using inside the clinic. So we learned about the different polymers, about sealants. That was a big thing because as a dental hygienist, you'll be placing lots of sealants. And so we learned about those type of materials, amalgams, and it kind of worked hand in hand because we knew how to place the sealants from tooth morphology, you understand? So it was really good. And we also had pre-clinic lab and pre-clinic lecture. So in pre-clinic
lecture,
we learned about like the infection control stuff mostly, and just everything you needed to know beforehand. And inside clinic lab, we learned about instrumentation a bit more, practicing on our type of don, how to actually go about with the movements of instrumentation. So after the fall 2019 semester, we went into the spring 2020 semester, and y'all know the year of 2020 had a lot going on, so things kind of got kind of mixed up. But this was basically what we took in the spring semester. We took radiology, and that's a lab and a lecture. We took clinic one, that's a lab and a lecture, and we also took periodontology. So radiology, as the name basically suggests, we learned mostly about x-rays, permissible doses, like how much we should expose to our patients, how to actually take it, the placement, and even common errors and how to correct those errors. And so we had lab where we'll actually go in and practice on, we call the type of dont like decks. So it was a whole face and we would place it in and then close it to adjust the bite so that it'll stay on the bite stick. And then we had lecture where we'll go in and really use our book and PowerPoints to, well, not PowerPoints. We used our book to learn about errors and actually see them, how to correct them, the dosage and all of those things. And then we had clinic one where we went over more things like went over fluoridation, different type of bites, the occlusion, malocclusion. And so basically what we learned inside lecture we brought to lab, and I think this was the semester that we actually started seeing patients too. So it's mostly about the assessment work, and so that's what we kind of focused on in lecture, understanding how to assess a patient. And then we had a periodontology, which I really loved. We learned all about the periodontium, we learned about common types of periodontal diseases, whether it's like where it's like NUG or NUP, aggressive gingivitis. We learned about the chronic and the acute diseases and all of those things. So it was really fun. And then we had summer, so we didn't skip summer and go from like spring to fall again. We go straight through. Okay, so we had the summer of 2020, and in this course we kind of went online now. And so we had pharmacology and pain control, and then we also had clinic two lecture and lab. So pharmacology was really fun. Honestly, I felt like I learned a lot about that because I didn't know too much about medications, and so I understand how they group the medications, whether it was like a for pain control or for the GI tract or like antidiuretic. So we just went over all type of different type of medications. We even went over those that are used for high blood pressure. And basically in pharmacology, you have to learn the whole body again somewhat, because you have to understand what the medication is actually targeting. So you go over the parasympathetic system, the sympathetic system, CNS, PNS. So that's the whole spiel with pharmacology. It was really fun, and it'll help you even understand when you're just going to the like Walmart or so for a painkiller, you know which one to get. So that was basically pharmacology. And then for clinic two lecture and lab, it was kind of the same thing. We just advanced in lecture about more conditions, we go over fluoridation again, assessment, different type of things we'll be seeing inside the oral cavity. And inside lab we're now seeing more advanced patients, so we're moving on our way to type 2 patients. So then we had fall 2020, and so in fall 2020 we had continued off on clinic 2 lab because we didn't get to finish it due to the whole situation with the pandemic. We also had clinic 3 lab, which was really good. It was a lot more advanced. We're seeing type 3 patients now, we're seeing type 4 patients, and so basically we have a type in an R program, and so that's basically periodontally involved patients, heavy calculus, bleeding. And so we also took in fall 2020 biochemistry and nutrition. So as the name suggests, you basically learn all the nutrients again, minerals, vitamins, how they work on the body, and basically the deficiencies that it would cause if you don't have enough of that vitamin or mineral. And then you guys, it was spring 2021, which I'm currently in right now, and we're going over oral pathology and pathophysiology. We're taking community dental health, clinic 4 lecture, and clinic 4 lab. Okay, and so oral pathology is basically the study of the diseases inside the oral cavity. So we're learning all about the different things that we'll be seeing, whether it's anything actually abnormal or even a variant of normal. So we go from as far as linear alba, which you guys learn about, up into like squamous carcinoma cell, all type of different pathologies. And inside community, we're learning about things that happen in the community. So basically epidemiology studies, we're learning about fluoridation so far, and that's where we're at so far. And inside clinic 4 lab, we are definitely seeing heavy patients. We are even going on rotation, so sometimes we're in clinic and sometimes we're at other people's actual practice, working out there, getting in time, and also seeing patients. And inside lecture, we're going over mostly things like ethics and law, and that's going to be heavy hitters on the board too. And you definitely need to know your law and your ethics, and just the whole legislature and protocols needed to be a dental hygienist, because you don't want to lose your license over something simple, over something minor. Okay, so basically you guys, that was the breakdown of the dental hygiene program. Those were the 6 semesters. Again, it was summer, fall, spring, back to the summer, fall, and then spring. And that's going to be taking about 1.5 years, okay? So that's the program. The time really does fly by, okay? Because when I was writing down what I did semester by semester, I felt like I just did tooth morphology last semester. And that's like basically a year ago. So the time definitely goes by. You're going to be constantly learning new things, and the key is to go back and study the things that you first began learning. I'm actually going to do a video about how to survive dental hygiene school, so stay tuned for that. But you guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe to this channel to show your appreciation. Hit your post notification bell so you don't miss any more uploads, and so you can stay up to date when I post another dental hygiene related video. Don't forget to like and comment down below your feedback. If you have any questions or if you want to suggest any videos, go ahead and comment that down below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys later. Bye.